How not to waste your money on piano lessons, tip number 4. This one may be a little controversial. Get your piano in your home and live with it there for a while. Whether you're going to be buying it, whether you're going to be getting your parents' piano from your childhood home, or whether you're going to be renting, which if you're a little afraid of the financial commitment of a piano, that could be an option for you. Do it before the time that you start lessons to give your kids a chance to get curious. Every parent, when they start lessons, tells me that they want their kids to have fun in lessons. They want their kids to enjoy it, and they don't want it to be a chore that they just have to nag about. And that starts with the kids wanting the lessons in the first place. That starts with the kids playing around on the piano and getting curious. That starts with them trying some things, and maybe if they're even a little older, maybe trying out some YouTube tutorials and kind of hitting a wall and saying, I wanna learn how to actually play this thing. That is a really good place to start lessons. Now, the idea of them going on YouTube on their own and looking at a tutorial and saying, oh, I still kind of can't do it, that's usually with the kids who are a little bit older. Your five-year-old is not going to be doing that. But your five-year-old might be banging around on the piano, and they might try to make up their own sounds on the piano, make up their own song, or they might, some might even try to figure out a song by ear. That's not typical, so don't worry if your kid isn't doing that. And if your kid has had a chance to get enthusiastic and get curious before they ever start lessons, then we get off on a really good foot and we make really good progress right from the beginning. And then we can take that momentum that we get from that early progress to continue making good progress. And that's really gonna help your kids get the most out of lessons.